Do subscribe to Ikeda channel and press bell icon to get updates about latest engineering, HSE and IIT JEE main and advanced videos.
Hello friends, in the last lecture we have studied about how the enthalpy changes when a physical transition happens, and it was related to the change from solid to liquid or liquid to gas, as well as we have also did for enthalpy of atomization, ionization and enthalpy change in solution and etc. So now during this process what happens is now we are going to talk about enthalpy of a reaction. Means in a reaction this process might take place, and overall how much amount of the enthalpy gets changed during this process will be the heat of reaction or enthalpy of reaction. So let us talk about it. So now let us talk about what is heat of reaction or enthalpy of a reaction. So the heat of reaction or enthalpy of a chemical reaction is nothing but the difference between the sum up of all the enthalpies of product and the sum up of all the enthalpies of the reactant. With every substance in a definite physical state and its amount, that is the number of moles, represented by coefficients in a balanced equation. So the enthalpy of a particular reaction, it is very much simple to understand. It is nothing but the enthalpy of the product, the sum of enthalpy of the product and the minus the sum of enthalpy of the reactant. And if we do this thing, then whatever the amount that we get will be the amount of the energy or the enthalpy that has been changed during this process. So let me talk more deep about this thing, is that we should always consider that the reaction that we have or on which we are studying, that should be thermodynamically or that should be stoichiometrically balanced. So if that has been balanced, and then it would be very much easy to understand, because this deals with the change in enthalpy when all the reactants or all the products have a particular coefficient, that is the stoichiometry associated with it. And during that, whatever change we observe, that would be a precise change in enthalpy during that process. So let me give you more detail about this thing, that what is actually heat of a reaction. It is a very simple concept, but yes, the enthalpy change that accompanies a chemical reaction is enthalpy of a reaction. Means in a chemical reaction, the change that it occurs, that the enthalpy change that occurs for a chemical reaction, that is nothing but the enthalpy of a reaction or heat of the reaction. It is denoted by delta H, and that delta H can be positive, can be negative. We are going to talk about it later, but we should understand that how can we calculate the delta H of a particular reaction. So suppose we have a reaction like A moles of A plus B moles of B, that gives us C moles of C and D moles of D. So this is the reaction that we have, and in this case what we observe is that the A and B, the both are been reactants, while the C and D are the products, and the small a, small b are the coefficients or the stoichiometry coefficients of the reactants A and B respectively, while that of the small c and small d are the stoichiometric coefficients of that the number of moles of product, that is C and D respectively. So therefore the heat of reaction in this process can be easily calculated as by this formula. The formula is, that is, the delta H is equals to summation of enthalpy of the product minus summation of enthalpy of the reactant. So this can be also be written as summation of HP, that is the enthalpy of the product, minus summation of HR, that is the enthalpy of the reactant. So since the product in product, what was been we have observed that it has C moles of C while D moles of D. So similarly here also we could see that now how to calculate this thing. So because small c was the stoichiometric value, so that's the reason we are now multiplying that stoichiometric value with the enthalpy of the product C. So therefore C will be multiplied by the enthalpy of the product C, plus D was the number of moles of the capital D that we had. Suppose it is a product, so again it will be multiplied by the enthalpy of D. So this is basically the sum up of the product that we had, minus A moles of A now will be multiplied by the enthalpy of A plus B moles of B now will be multiplied by the enthalpy of B. So this will be the sum up of the reactants. So if we do this subtraction, or if we make out a difference between them, so that will be nothing but the enthalpy of the reaction. For example, I have an example in my mind. Suppose if it is 2 times of carbon plus H2, so it will give me C2H2. And again, carbon is present in solid while hydrogen has been present in a gaseous state. And again, this is ethene that we will get. Again, it will be present in a gaseous state. So in this case, the delta H which was found to be, it was around somewhere plus 226.0 kilojoule per mole. So this implies what? So this is nothing but the heat of reaction, which means that suppose if carbon and hydrogen, the both come together to each other and they react with each other so as to form ethene. But in this thing we should also mention, and we should also observe, that the stoichiometric values are also been given. That is, 2 moles of carbon now will be engaged with the H2 molecule so as to form 1 mole of C2H2, that is ethene. So in this, for to keep in this mind, then only the value of delta H has been for this reaction, it was plus 226.0 kilojoule, means this much amount of energy has been released when carbon was being reacted with hydrogen so as to form ethene. So this is nothing but the heat of reaction or the enthalpy of the reaction. But this is for a particular reaction, that is for formation of ethene. But for different reaction, it would have a different value, and it will depend that whether the value will have a positive magnitude or a negative magnitude. So talking about the next one also, so this was related to the it was related to the enthalpy of the reaction. But yes, we have also another condition in which the same enthalpy of the reaction can be calculated, but the condition will be different. And what is the condition? Let us talk about that. So now we are going to talk about standard enthalpy of reaction. So the difference between the enthalpy of a reaction and standard enthalpy of a reaction is that in standard enthalpy, the conditions are set to be or are set to be in a standard values. For example, the pressure, which is basically, it should be set at 1 atmosphere. The temperature, it should be set at 25 atmosphere. So that is nothing but the standard enthalpy of the reaction that we have. Suppose in this thing, so as to learn the definition of this thing, it is nothing but the enthalpy change accompanying the reaction when all the substances are involved in their standard states. So in this case, if all the substances are been kept or are been considered or are been studied in a standard state, that kind of enthalpy change that we will observe for a reaction will be nothing but the standard enthalpy of a reaction. And now it has been denoted by delta H naught. So it is very much similar to that, but the conditions are been different. That condition would have varying pressure or varying temperature, but in this case, the temperature and the pressure are set to be in a standard state. So this is the difference. So thank you, friends, for watching this video. I hope you have understood this video very clearly, that what does the heat of reaction or enthalpy of reaction means. And we are going to solve the numericals of this too in our lectures also. So share this video with the friends, and yes, don't forget to subscribe to E-Kida channel. Thank you so much.